With the rise of social media, next year's elections will see more influencers and content creators trying their luck in the political arena. Paige Javier with this special report.
After gaining popularity on social media, a number of online personalities are now seeking a career in politics. Some are vying for a national post, while others are seeking local positions in the 2025 midterm elections. Among them is Deo Balbuena, more known as Diwata, the fourth nominee of Vendor's party list. Content creator and entrepreneur Rosemary Tan Pamulaklakin, or Rosmar Tan, is also on the list, as she aims to be a councillor in the 1st District of Manila. The aspirants say they are running to help others.
Siguro naman mas marami nakakilala sa akin para magkaroon po ng boses ang bawat vendor, ang bawat manindang Pilipino.
May nag-push po sa akin na tumakbo ka kasi kailangan ka ng tao, kasi kailangan nila ng tunay na pagbabago. Sabi ko siguro nga mas marami akong matutulungan kapag nakaposisyon na po ako.
UP National College of Public Administration and Governance Professor Erwin Alampay is not surprised with the development.
It's just a new media, no different from mga artista na tumatakbo or basketball players na tumatakbo, di ba? Parang ganun, they're leveraging their popularity to run.
Veteran campaign strategist Alan Herman agrees.
The new batch of entertainers that are captivating our attention right now are the online influencers and the so-called SOCMED stars. Every day, day in, day out, they are bolstered. Their confidence is bolstered by seeing the likes, the shares, the comments, the views, and they see that these are in the millions. And then in their heads, they're thinking, 300,000 lang naboto, congressman ako, why not? Walang mawawala.
But for Contradaya convener Danilo Arau, influencers must clarify some things to voters.
Sino ang nagtulak sa iyo para tumakbo?
Yan.
Pangalawa, sino ang nagpupondo ng kandidatura mo?
Yun.
At pangatlo, kahit na sabihin independent ka, kanino ka aliado or kanino ka allied na halimbawa political dynasty o big business?
Just like celebrities, social media personalities have been criticized for their lack of knowledge in politics.
Hayaan niyo muna ako bigyan ng pagkakataon, di ba? Bago niyo ako husgahan. So, yun. Gagawin ko lahat ang kakayahan ko.
Masasabi ko naman po na matalino po akong tao. At hindi po doon nagtatapos yung pagiging politiko.
Professor Alampay believes aspirants don't have to know it all before they assume their post.
We can't generalize that all influencers are bad. Mayroong mga influencers kasi doktor sila, di ba? So health, sana health related. The process of lawmaking naman, you could always study that. I think the more important thing for them is dapat klaro what priorities they want. It's not just about to help, but very particular to the issues.
Experts believe there may be a deeper reason why influencers and content creators are seeking public office.
Sometimes yung influencers can also influence the elections in other ways, like the negative information, and or it could be a way of taking votes from others. Feeling ko some of them are running either to influence, can influence an outcome, and not necessarily just to win.
Some popular social media personalities who have expressed their intention to run have thousands or millions of followers. But the question is, can these translate to votes?
Just because you're an influencer and you've got millions of views, likes, engagement on social media, it does not always translate. Social media following is not enough. It helps, but it's not enough. There has to be something substantive under it. Lahat ba yan, bumoboto? Dahil baka iba dyan, hindi voting age. That's one. Number two, lahat ng followers mo, pag sinusundan nila yung may ibang kandidato din, nawala na yung advantage mo.
Experts remind voters to avoid using their admiration of a social media personality as basis to vote. What they should look for is if the aspirants have good influence and if this will extend to their time in public office. Based on previous elections, not all content creators are able to attain victory. Take for instance vlogger Mocha Uson, who vied for a party-less seat in 2022 but lost.
You have to perform. Hindi ka pwedeng umasa na lang sa pangalan mo.
Paige Javier, ABS-CBN News.
The United Nations Security Council expressing strong concern after several UN peacekeeping positions in southern Lebanon came under fire amid clashes between Israel and Hezbollah. The 15-member council urges all parties to respect the safety and security of UNIFIL and reiterates its importance for regional stability. The UN says since the start of Israeli ground operations in Lebanon, UNIFIL positions have been affected 20 times, with 5 peacekeepers injured during the incidents. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has rejected accusations Israeli troops had deliberately targeted UNIFIL peacekeepers. The Philippines opens a week-long Asia-Pacific summit on disaster risk reduction, with President Marcos reaffirming his administration's commitment to addressing climate change. Our correspondent Pia Gutierrez now joins us with more. Pia, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Tuesday called on countries in the Asia-Pacific region to redouble their efforts to reduce disaster risks in order to secure a sustainable and climate-resilient future. The Philippine leader made a statement as he led the opening of the Asia-Pacific Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction. It's a biennial international event which aims to reduce the risk and impact of disasters in the world's most disaster-prone region. In his speech, the president noted that as countries in the Asia-Pacific continue to face increasing threats brought about by climate change, there is a need to strive to create a future where the need for disaster recovery becomes less frequent, all while laying the foundations towards a safer, more adaptive, inclusive, and disaster-resilient region. Let's listen to President Marcos Jr.
Resilience and sustainability must underpin the national agenda of our economy. This recognizes that all our efforts in economic planning are fragile in the face of calamities and disaster. For us, the stakes are existential, the consequences generational, and the policy environment increasingly complex. We must strive to create a future where the need for recovery becomes less frequent, as we lay the foundations for a safer, more adaptive, inclusive, and disaster-resilient region.
Marcos Jr. also called for the establishment of stronger international legal frameworks that will guide disaster prevention and response, particularly in ensuring the protection of persons in the event of disasters. The Philippines, he says, is proud to lead the initiative toward developing an international legal instrument for the protection of persons in the event of disasters. This, as he notes, that as climate change and disasters are catalysts for human displacement, it is necessary to put in place forward-thinking policies that, he says, will create safe pathways for migration and will support those displaced by disasters so that they can rebuild their lives with dignity and security. Carmina, the Asia-Pacific Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction will run until October 18. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Pia Gutierrez there joining us on the line.